In the previous unit, we got familiar with FlexBee and its user interface, and how we can easily start designing a behavior by drag and dropping states in the state machine editor. However, to completely implement a behavior with FlexBee, we need to configure its different states for our particular application. In this unit, we will learn step by step how to define the data for our FlexBee behavior, so that it can be used later to configure the states in its state machine. Okay, let's go back to the behavior dashboard view. This is where we will define the data for our behavior. First, consider the information that is constant during our behavior. For example, the robot arm that picks the part from the conveyor, which is robot 1. Remember that in week 4, you learned to define groups with the Move It Setup Assistant, here you have it, to distinguish which robot to command each time. So it seems useful to define a constant for the group that will pick the part in our case. This is the same as a constant in programming languages. Instead of using a literal value every time, which can cause errors if we want to change it, we just define a constant with the value and use the constant in our state. Here is how we do it. In FlexBee, we define constants in the private configuration section. So, we can define a constant named pgroup and give it as value a string with the name of the group that we define for the robot in the conveyor belt, which is robot1. To enter a literal value, we use quotation marks. Now, let's consider information that can change during the execution of our behavior, being passed between states. This is called user data in FlexBee. For example, in our behavior, the detect part state obtains the pose of the part to pick, which is used by the compute pick state to obtain the joint configuration the robot needs to move to pick the part. So we have two variables whose values are produced at runtime by states and used by other states. This is the pose of the part and the joint configuration where to move the robot to pick the part. So for the first one, we can define the user data variable part pose. Here it is. And for the second one, the user data pick configuration. So we type it there. Yes. Here it goes. Okay. Note that we always need to define a default value for each user data. This is like initializing a variable in programming. In the case of part pose, we can simply set it to an empty array. So we do it like that. However, for pick configuration, we should set a safe value. This is because if for any reason the default value is used during the execution of the behavior, the robot would move to that position. So the group state R1 home that we defined for robot1 in the SRDF file seems a safe option. So we can put as default value the joint values in the R1 home group state. But wait, this is a constant value, right? So we can define it as a constant in private configuration. Here it is. And we use that constant and as the default value for this user data. Here is how we can do it. First, we define the home1 constant and set its value and as an array containing the joint values for R1 home group state. Now, we use home1 as the default value for the pick configuration user data. And we are done. We have defined our first user data variables. All right. In this video, we have learned how we can define the two different types of data for our behavior, constant values and user data variables. In the next videos, we will see how we configure the states in the state machine to use this behavior data.